This is where it all starts, in the newsroom. All these people, all busy sifting the news.
Okay, Khan, can we deal with the news schedule now? The main thing's obviously going to be the mini-budget tomorrow, so make that the top item.
First, someone has to decide what news to cover. That person is the news editor.
The GLC, next year's rate to be 17%. Commons, devolution debate enters second day. Murder, a jeweler aged 36.
Once he's decided which stories to cover, he has to get a reporter to each story to cover them.
You got a moment?
Yeah, sure.
There's a good story coming up this morning in about 25 minutes. The London coach drivers, you know, those chaps who take the tourists around,
they're
all complaining that the traffic wardens and the police are harassing them. Do you think you could go down and perhaps ride around on one of the coaches when they have their demonstration and see how it works
out?
Certainly.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
How would that be?
It'd be fine. Have you told the picture desk?
I haven't told pictures. Will you get them to have a cameraman there?
Most certainly. I'll go
okay.
over there.
Fine.
Hello. Hello. Copy?
Yeah.
Hello, Stephen Claxton here. Okay, a token force.
Yeah.
Of London tourist coaches. Made an assault on the West Ends, that's apostrophe S. Rush hour this morning. Set off from a coach park behind Millbank, one word, at figures 8:30.
The story, along with the work of all the other journalists, is now being made into a newspaper. First of all, it has to be subbed, cut, and if necessary, altered. Then it goes by conveyor to the compositor's room. Here, it's set up in type. And of course, it has to be read and corrected. And then, still with urgency and among increasing noise, it has to be printed. Here are the presses rolling with our story.